Hi everyone, this is James. I thought I'd give a quick 5 tips. Little things, but important things for inline hockey goaltenders. The first is skipping head. So by skipping your head, I mean you've got a situation where you're concentrating on the puck carrier, you're setting up fairly as if there's going to be a shot, but you appreciate there's a shooter out wide. What I would like to see from people and what I brought into my game is looking across to see where the open man is as they become more dangerous, and being prepared with an explosive push if the pass develops to get to them, get a straight line between them and the goal, and hopefully make a save. A few key facts here: if the pass is made and there's no chance of an interception, I would like you to skip your head. Don't watch the puck as it travels across from one stick to the other. Actually skip. You see I tap my stick, then you can just literally from that point, as soon as it's left the stick 2 or 3 inches, skip your head to the other forward stick, in which case it will help you to get square and get to the exact point of where the shot is then going to be released. So skip your head from one stick to the next. There's not going to be any kind of interference. The puck's going to get there, so there's no risk and you're going to be in much better position. The next one is a desire, so level 2, a desire to have shots not go through you or under you. Make this a focus of training and games and pretty much whenever you're in the kit. If shots don't go through you or under you, I can guarantee your season this year is going to be fantastic. Third point is hand-to-eye coordination. I kind of brought juggling into my game maybe a year ago now. I definitely don't regret it. It just kind of tells your mind and your body, or at least for me, you're here and you're ready to play hockey. Let's get your hands and eyes into it. Let's not have any pop-outs from your glove. Let's track it all the way to the sides or into your pads or into your body. It's a mental and physical thing for me. I would suggest everyone gives juggling a try. It's very simple to get the hang of. Spend some time over Christmas now, and you could have it nailed. Thirdly is, if you've got a chance, play without a stick. It could be a session a month, it could be half a session a month, but this will do a couple of things. Firstly, it will give you appreciation for how important your stick is, how much harder you have to work without it, but additionally is a good workout. It really works on your down speed, and also it should mean that you use it as a more effective tool going forward. I probably should mention, as you can see, it's not exactly easy. You probably find this quite tiring. Yeah, right, stop being a wimp, get up now. Last one is get some video. Here I'm making some, well, what I would have thought would be standard saves, but at varying depths. And you can see that because of the video and having an appreciation of your size and depth, some saves based on your depth are inappropriate. And really, the best way for you to visualise this yourself is to get some video, take some different angles, and then see what's appropriate and what isn't. Thanks very much.